Satnam, everyone. So today's practice is about really physically and emotionally stimulating the root chakra, the sex chakra, and the third chakra to release trauma from the cells, from the tissues, clear out any stagnation of the sex organs, of the reproductive organs. And psychologically, this kriya powerfully affects our neuroses and the ways in which we sort of wrap ourselves up in actions, patterns, behaviors that don't serve our highest good, yet somehow we're not able to break free of them. This kriya is particularly good for addictions of any kind. And as you can see, I'm sitting outside in the pouring rain and I'm following my philosophy on life that there is a way through every block. So right now I didn't have a space inside to record a video, so here I am outside. So we're on a rainy adventure together, no matter where you are or what the weather is for you. Bring your palms together at the heart. Lengthen the spine tall. Lift the heart and the chin. Take a deep inhale to tune in. Om Namo Gurudev Namo. Om Namo Gurudev Namo. Om Namo Gurudev Namo. Inhale deeply. Fill your lungs with this precious breath. Hold the breath in, concentrate at the third eye. And exhale. So we're going to come into a position, bringing the heels together, grabbing hold of the toes, chest and heart lifted, chin gently tucked in towards the back of the spine. We're going to begin a spinal flex here, really feeling your root, your sit bones, and your pelvis. Inhaling, arching your spine forward, and exhaling, rounding back. Allow this movement and the breath especially to begin to open up and release the tension in your pelvic bowl. Feel your perineum, your sex organs, your genitals all releasing tension down into the earth through that sacred cord connecting you to the Great Mother. On the inhale, expanding the pelvis with breath, and on the exhale, releasing any tension down into the earth. Unify the energy of the pelvis and the heart together. Relax your thighs. And inhale deeply to a straight spine. Suspend your breath and contract the root lock, squeezing in and up on the sex organs, drawing the navel in towards the back of the spine. Suspend the breath and hold. And exhale, release. Transitioning to lying on your stomach. Placing the palms underneath your shoulders. Gently engaging the core and abdominal muscles, slowly rising up into a half cobra. Inhaling up to a straight back plank position. And exhaling, lowering the hips down to the cobra, opening up through the heart, releasing tension through the heart. Continue inhaling up. And exhaling down at the pace of your own body. Relax the shoulders, relax your throat and your neck. Continue at your own pace, fast and vigorous to build heat or slow and gentle. Inhale into the plank position and exhale, release. Coming back into a squatting position. Heels and ankles in line with the hips. Heels flat on the floor or ground, if possible. You're going to interlace your fingers in Venus Mudra. So interlacing the fingers together and pressing the left thumb on the outside of the right hand, the pad of the right thumb. Gently hooking your elbows around the knees. Ground down into the earth, let the pelvis settle into this primal posture. Straighten through the spine, and we're going to begin a powerful breath of fire here, powerfully pumping the lower abdomen. And begin. Allow your spine to be straight like the trunk of a tree and let the breath move powerful waves of warm energy up the spine from the root of your body. You can imagine that you are a seed or a hot flame bursting upwards towards the light. Last 30 seconds, keep up. Take a deep inhale. Suspend your breath, lifting the crown of the head towards the heavens. Exhale and release. Make your way slowly to a position lying on your back. Legs out in front. You're going to lie in corpse pose with your palms facing down on either side of the body and begin inhaling both legs up to 90 degrees, keeping the knees straight, and exhaling, lowering them down completely. You can place your hands beneath your lower back to support your hips and your buttocks if you need to. Otherwise, really engage your core and use your core as the fulcrum that brings your legs up and down, and begin. Continue. You're going to be here for one more minute. Let your breath flow from the root of the spine to the crown of the head on the inhale as the legs rise. And on the exhale, imagine the breath sweeping through the body from the crown of the head to the root. Inhaling up, sweeping through the spine, and exhaling down, sweeping back down to the earth. Allow the heat to build in your abdomen, in your third chakra, creating the necessary fire and resistance to burn through any blockages. Beautiful, and inhale the legs up to 90 degrees. And exhale, lower them down. Take a moment to feel your body in relation to the earth. Let her hold you. let her hold the conflict, the resistance, the fire, the inspiration. Let her cradle you just as you are. Slowly making your way onto your stomach, interlacing your fingers in the same mudra we did before, behind the lower back. You're going to raise the upper body up off the mat, lifting the heart, and begin a breath of fire. Continue powerfully pumping the navel against the floor, feeling the heat in your pelvis, feeling the pressure of the pubic bone. If you need to, you can lower your chest down to the floor, continuing with the breath of fire and rising back up again as is comfortable, but continue to hold this vision. Activating the Kundalini Shakti, the mother serpent energy, so related to the divine feminine, so related to our sexuality. Allow this vision of the serpent within your pelvis to uncoil and transform and heal. Last 10 seconds. And suspend the breath up into the arched position. And exhale, releasing down to the mat, relaxing your body completely. Again, feeling the weight and the support and the nurturing embrace of the earth. Let go completely. Now roll over onto your back, palms facing up, and rest with the front of your body open to receive from the upper realms. Feel the energy of rain, the image of cleansing water washing over you. As your entire being is gently cleansed. acknowledge that it is just a higher aspect of yourself which is cleansing you. Bring your knees into your chest and rock forward and backwards along the spine. Rolling up into a seated position. Just checking in with your body, noticing each side of the pelvis. How does the left side of the pelvis feel in comparison to the right side of the pelvis? You can take a moment if you have a pad of paper or your journal nearby to create an image or some words that represent the movement that is happening through the second chakra. Now notice how the front of the heart feels in comparison to the back of the heart. As we move into the final movements of our Kriya, allow the front and the back of the heart to be equally soft and receptive. Healing comes from the heart. And we have to be tender with ourselves in order to transform. Coming onto your back with your feet flat on the ground and your knees pointing up, lower your spine down to the floor. You're going to lift your hips up, placing the hands beneath the pelvis, and in whatever way is most comfortable for you, come into a gentle shoulder stand, keeping your neck relaxed. If you feel tension or pain in your neck or spine at all, you can lower the angle of your hips down, or just lie with your legs straight at 90 degrees. We'll begin a breath of fire in the shoulder stand position. Now, if possible, lowering the feet over the head into a plow pose or just keeping them at a right angle.
inhale, bringing your knees in towards your chest and rocking down vertebra by vertebra along the spine to a flat back, releasing the legs out, resting here, unfolding the inversion.
And I hope you are able to tune in and feel the absolute cleansing that is happening right now in the rain, the element of water flushing out any residual tension and shadow and conflict in the second chakra, allowing whatever energy is there to flow, to release, to be seen, to be heard. We're going to come into a position sitting on our knees. We're coming into what's called celibate pose, which is very stimulating for the second chakra. So if this is okay for your knees, you're actually going to sit with your heels on the outside of your buttocks with your knees inverted so that there is nothing in between your sex organs and the earth. If you need to, if this is too uncomfortable, you can take a blanket or a pillow and put it in between your legs to support this. Or you can simply just sit on your heels as I am going to do. Lifting the spine tall. Interlacing the fingers with the index finger pointed forward. Above the head, arms straight, spine long. We will chant Sat, bringing the navel in towards the back of the spine, and Nam as the navel releases. Sat, Nam, Sat, Nam, Sat, Nam, Sat, Nam, Sat, Nam, Sat. Nam, Sat, 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 Nam, Nam, Sat, 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 Nam. Let the sound spring forth from your navel. Sat, Nam, 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 Sat, Nam. Take a deep inhale. Stretch the arms up above the head, squeeze from the base of the spine to the crown of the head, contract the root lock, lift in and up on the perineum, hold, let the energy rise. And exhale, suspend the breath out, hold, squeeze, lift the arms up. And exhale, release the arms down. Come into a restful position, lying on your back, palms facing up. Listening to the sound of the rain, visualizing this cleansing water pouring through your body. Relax the ankles, relax your shins, relax your womb. Let the shoulders relax, the shoulder blades, the wrists of your hands, your face. Allow your body to melt. As the energy in your body begins to settle, travel down into the space of your womb. Your eyes are closed, and feel yourself sitting inside the great bowl of your pelvis. Just notice how it feels here. What is the temperature? What do you see? Are there any sensations greeting you? Continue to rest here with an awareness of complete love and compassion for yourself. You are coming into the relationship with the root of your power. And as you're ready, slowly begin to bring your awareness to the rest of your body. Moving yourself in any way that feels comfortable before returning to a seated position. Notice the clarity and the shift since the beginning of our practice. Again, acknowledging the steadfastness, the grace, and the beauty amidst discomfort, amidst unpredictability. How this experience allows us to remember our power. We're going to come into a meditation now, specifically for healing a broken heart. We all have had our heart broken in our life, and this meditation is so beautiful because it works on not just the break that we experience with another human being, but the break that we experience sometimes in our life from our self, our capital S self. And the body is so gentle and wise that it experiences this break from the self or the other as if you've had a physical injury. It's really a shock to the nervous system. And these shocks live inside of us for as long as we allow them to. They can live with us for years and years and years after we've experienced the disconnection from the self or the heart of another or our own self. So this meditation is going to slowly begin to repair that break. Place your palms together and really make sure that you feel an even pressure between the hands. Now, the functionality of this meditation works primarily on the pressure between the pinky fingers. So really make sure that you can feel the outward side of the hand pressing against the other hand. With a straight spine, you're going to lift the hand so that the tip of the middle finger is at a few inches above the third eye point. Not touching, but just in front of the third eye point. And we'll breathe long and deep here as the muscles, the nerves, and the glands readjust. The emotions will flow and the nervous system will come into balance. And begin. Allow yourself to call up any images or memories related to this past split, this break. Focus on every moment of the breath as it passes through you. Allow yourself to be. Allow this healing to be soft and gentle. You don't need to experience everything fully in the pain that it was. You are a new sovereign being. You are whole. the elbows lifted out to the side, keeping the heart and chest open. How deep can you sustain the breath? Last 2 minutes, allow yourself to go deep. Thank you. and interlace the fingers. Stretch them above the head, tall. Breathe here with long, slow, deep breathing, lifting the heart, solidifying the weaving together of the magnetic field of the aura. Hands are interlaced. Smile. Be like the tree, rooted from the earth, rising towards infinity. Anchoring, rooting and solidifying everything that you have integrated during this practice. Keep the arms up. Take a deep inhale. And exhale, release the arms down. Allow yourself to bask in your own beauty. You are an absolutely amazing human being. These practices allow us to have a form, a shape, and a practice through which we realize our infinite potential. But the practices are just a shell without our own presence, our own work. Everything that you create, that you see, that you live through, is yours to transform. It's yours to elevate, and it's yours to heal. You have the power. And so it is. We'll close with three long satnams. Inhale deeply and chant from the heart. Sa. Waheguruji ka khalsa, Waheguruji ki fateh. Let us dedicate the peace, the presence, and the power of this practice to every single being we meet we interact with, and to all beings everywhere.